worried all the week. Why me? I'm not interested.
You're not interesting.
No.
You don't think the fact that you're 102 is not interesting?
103.
I'm 103.
100, oh, okay, excuse me.
Yeah.
You don't think?
No, I don't think so. Yeah.
Well, that's very modest of you. Do you realize that living to 103 is pretty unusual?
Is it really?
Yeah.
Good.
We learned that centenarians tend to live into their 90s on their own. They're delaying age-associated illnesses and cognitive impairment, even though they have the number one risk factor for Alzheimer's disease and dementia, which is advanced age. Many of them were living to age 100 without dementia. So they must have some type of resilience to Alzheimer's disease. Traditionally, studies have always looked at people with Alzheimer's disease to try to understand it. And here we're really flipping it on its head. We're looking at the reverse. How do you avoid Alzheimer's disease? And what therapies can we develop from that?
We're going to show you what it's like to do some of this testing using a computer.
Oh.
Okay.
I don't know nothing about a computer.
I know. That's why we're here.
Oh, I see.
Okay. I barely know that, too.
Yeah.
All right?
Uh-huh. We'll put you here, and you're going to talk to our colleague. Hey, Parsh, are you there?
So we're doing very careful cognitive function testing. We're getting a detailed medical history. We get a detailed family history, just a whole slew of data. The idea is to understand what genes are protecting the centenarian from developing the disease. All right, so we'll say goodbye.
Bye-bye.
See you, Parsh.
I think the average bunch of us should be able to get to about 90, and much of that because of healthy behaviors.
Instead of the older you get, the sicker you get, it's the older you get, the healthier you've been. Your lifestyle factors, having good healthy habits, having good social networks.
You're looking beautiful, Hilda.
Yeah, I look big as a cow. I was born in 2/28/11. I'm 112 years old. When I was 4 years old, my sister brought me to Woburn to stay with my aunt and uncle. My aunt did not have indoor plumbing. I was glad we got electricity. New things these children have today are so easy. The washing machines and the dryer. I didn't think I'd live this long to see it, but I did. Mm-hmm. That's me.
Every time I speak with a centenarian, it's a great joy. I mean, many of these people are these living historical treasures. You get firsthand accounts of just amazing events in the past 100 years.
I graduated in high school when the war broke out, 1931. They had rationing of food and gasoline. I wanted to become a nurse, and I went to City Hospital, and they told me they were only taking 2 blacks. But that time they had their quota, and I couldn't get in. So I went into domestic work. I was glad afterwards that I didn't become a nurse. I love working for the families. I've lived through quite a few presidents. Roosevelt, Johnson, Ford, Bill Clinton, my favorite. Of course, you know it's Obama.
It's been a wonderful opportunity to work with centenarians. You really get the opportunity to think back on your life, find meaning, and really come to a place of acceptance for your upcoming death. Centenarians talk very openly about death, and they really are at peace with it. And I think a lot of people would find comfort in that.
I've had a good life. Yeah, don't live too fast. Yeah, you have plenty of time to live.